It is finally October. The weather is cooling down and Halloween is right around the corner. This is the time of year that most people get in the mood for a nice horror film, or if you're a gamer, probably your favorite survival horror series. When you think of Capcom and horror, the first thing that probably comes to mind is Resident Evil. But there is one series that I remember seeing quite a bit during the Xbox 360 era, which is Dead Rising. Now, when Dead Rising was first released, it was exclusive to the Xbox 360. I remember this game being the talk of the town. Literally, all my friends who own 360s were just loving this game. I didn't know why, but Dead Rising, it just didn't do too much for me at that time. I wasn't really big on the whole zombie genre, and honestly, I'm kinda still not. But it wasn't until I got to play Dead Rising 3 for the Xbox One that I was intrigued on the series. Well, since it's horror month, why not take a look back on Capcom's zombie comedy classic, Dead Rising. For this review, I'm looking at the HD re-release that can be found on the PS4, Xbox One, and the PC. This offers better visuals, 60 FPS, and just a smoother experience overall. Does this game still hold up, and can I still recommend this even today? Well, let's get into it. The story for Dead Rising is fairly simple. You play as this freelance photographer named Frank West, who hears about these crazy events going on in the town of Willamette, Colorado. And no, this is not a real place. While flying over the town, he sees all sorts of chaos and confusion happening on the ground, and come to find out, there's a zombie apocalypse going on. Now, I won't get too deep into the story elements because I do want you all to experience this firsthand, but Frank ends up in this mall that houses thousands of zombies, psychopaths, and much more. Frank has 3 days to uncover the truth about what's going on in this town. During this, you meet tons of different characters and survivors, and honestly, it is a pretty fun time, and I found myself entertained throughout the entire adventure. The story is far from a masterpiece, but for a game like this, it works well. Frank is funny, some of the hostage situations are completely outrageous, and there are some fun twists and turns here that can get pretty interesting. Depending on how you did through your playthrough, you can get multiple endings, so definitely have a few goes at this. Now, let's get into the gameplay. So Dead Rising, the best way to describe this game is a zombie survival game. You are locked inside this mall for 3 days and you have to do whatever you can to survive, whether that's finding weapons to use, food to eat, and hostages to save. This is the draw of the series. You have so many options in terms of what you can do to defend yourself, and I love that. You can grab whatever you can find and make your way through hordes of zombies. You start off the game super underlevel, and it sucks because it seems like you can't even catch a break. Luckily, the game allows you to start over with your level still intact. You level up by doing escort missions, defeating psychopaths, and just killing zombies throughout the mall. Now, speaking of psychopaths, these act as like mini boss fights throughout your time in the mall, and in my opinion, these are the true standout moments in this game and the series as a whole. Just based on how ridiculous these fights are, the overweight mall cop, the psycho clown, and the hatchet man, which I hate personally. These psychos bring a ton of personality to the game, and it was very fun to fight each and every one of them. During your time here, you'll be notified by an older gentleman named Otis. He would tell you where the hostages are and where possible psychopaths are located. Otis can get a bit annoying, and the fact that you can't really defend yourself while he's briefing you, it can get intense. Also, the escort missions are super annoying because the AI is so bad in this game. I will cut it some slack because it is a game that came out in 06, but come on now. Sometimes you're just better off letting these guys just die. Now, zombies and psychopaths are not the only threat. Midway through the game, you will encounter cult members who are pretty damn dangerous and scary, but I will say it is super satisfying to pull off headshots on these guys. But the cult leader? Yo, he is a beast with a sword. You also have these inmates who ride around in this truck with a turret on the back. They are super annoying as well. Now, one mechanic of this game that I did not personally care for was the time mechanic. This game has events that start at a certain time, and if you are not in the security room or an era at that exact time, you can run the risk of ruining the entire story. This was something I did not care for. A better method would be to give the player a larger window of time. Also, story missions are never active until the very last minute, which was super annoying to me. Frank can also dress up in different outfits. I love Mega Man Legends, so I had to grab a Surfbot head for my playthrough, but there are plenty of clothing options for Frank to rock. You can also eat different food items to regain health. Stock up on orange juice and coffee creamer. They are the best. Weapons can range from guns, sword, and even random items that you will find in a mall. This game encourages you to explore each and every store, which I love. Overall, Dead Rising is a cool game. It is a perfect representation of a modern mall, and things can get pretty tense in here. The weapons and item variety is a major selling point for me, and the psychopaths are just the standouts for me. I did have some issues with the time mechanic, but I understand why it's here. The AI is also god-awful, but what can you say? Dead Rising is still a fun time and a game I can easily recommend. Buy the HD remaster for the best experience if you plan on playing this. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you next time.